Hello, good afternoon. Today we will see the topic number 4, that is seeds, its definition, characteristics of quality seed, seed treatment and its objectives of seed treatment, and then seed dormancy, causes of seed dormancy, and the multiple stages of seed. First of all, we can see the definition of seed. That is any material which is used for the used for planting or the sowing or the propagation of a crop is called as a seed. As a seed is an embryonic plant enclosed with the protective or outer covering, as the concept of seed. That is any plant which will be as a seed or the any propagating part, that is sexual propagating parts which are used for the planting or the propagation, that is called as the seed, or the embryonic plant which is enclosed with the protective outer covering, which is also called as the seed. Then another definition of the seed, that is the plant which grows into the new plant, that is ability of this planting material which is to produce the new plant, that is also called as the seed. Then grains or ripened ovules of the plant is used for sowing is also called as the seed, or the fertilizer oil that, or the flower of the flowering plant containing the embryo and the capable of normally used for the germination to produce the new plant, that is also called as the seed. That is the, in short, that is the seed means any material which is used for the sowing or planting or the propagation, or any embryonic plant which is enclosed with the protective outer covering is also called as the seed. And then seed also the any plant which is produce the new plant, that is also called as the seed. And then also the grain or ripened ovules of the plant which is used for sowing, this is also called as the seed. Next one, we can see the major quality characteristics of the seed. That is first one, physical quality, second one the genetic purity, third one the physiological quality, then seed health, and other qualities are also in the mentioned in this slide. First of all, we can see in detail, that is physical quality. In this case, the cleanness of seed from other seeds, that is debris, inert matter, diseased seeds or the insect damaged seeds, which is can cause or reduces these physical qualities of the seed. Then seed with the physical quality which have the uniform size, then weight and the color, and they free from the stones, debris, dust, leaf, wing stems, flower, fruit, as well as the other crop seeds, and also the inner matter, which is also free from of this inner matter or the other part planting materials. Then also they should avoid the shriveled or diseased, mottled or molded, discolored, damaged and empty seeds, which also can cause the physical qualities of the seed. These seeds should be easily identifiable, and the species of species category of the specific species is to be identified according to the different size, weight or the its contents, whatever the stones, debris, dust or the leaf, wing stems, flower, whatever the materials will be present, which we can discard or should be removed, and to maintain the physical purity or the quality of the seed. Next one, the genetic purity. In this case, the true type of the nature of the seed, that is seedling or the plant or the trees from the seed, which is resembled to its mother in all aspects. That is true to type of the seed, that is indicates the genetic purity. The quality character is important for the achieving the desired goal of the raising crop, either yield or the resistance of the desired quality factors. Next one, that is physiological quality. In this case, the actual expression of the seed in the further generation or the multiplication. As the physiological quality of the seed comprises the seed germination and the vigor. This is important part which will be indicates the physiological quality as germination and the vigor of the seed. Then liveliness of the seed is also is known as the viability, as the extent of liveliness or the viability of the seed is used for good seedling or the ability of seed for the production of the seedlings with the normal root and the shoot under favorable conditions, which is known as the germinability. This is the physiological qualities which will indicate the germination and vigor of the plants as well as the viability. An extent of the viability which will be depends on the good seedness or germination and the ability of seed. We have the normal root and the shoot under favorable conditions. Next one, that is seed health. The health status of the seed, nothing but the absence of insect infestation and the fungal infestation out on the seed. The seed should not be infected with fungi or the infected with insect pest, as well as these will be reduced by the physiological qualities of the seed and also the physical quality of the seed in the long term storage. The health status of the seed includes the deterioration status of the seed, which will be expressed through the low vigor status of the seed. As we can see here, in case of the physiologic test, it indicates the any infection. The fungal infections which will be observed, the health of the seed should be reduced. If the seeds are free from or absence of this any insect infestation on the fungal infestation, then seed should be called as a healthy seed. Then the qualities of these healthy seed should be indicates its better physiological qualities as well as the physical qualities of the seed. And then also the health status of the seed also includes the deterioration of this status of the seed. It is also expressed in the low vigor of the status of the seed. As the seed is infected with pest and disease, this will be categorized in the low vigor status. If the seed are free from the any insect pest or disease infestation, the seed will be categorized or expressed through the high vigor status of the seed. Next one, qualities, general qualities of the seed, which have the high genetic purity, high pure seed percentage, that is physical purity, then high germinability, then high vigor, high field establishment, free from pest and disease, good shape, color, size according to specification of the variety, then high longevity or the shelf life, then optimum moisture content for the storage and the high market value. These are the important qualities of the seed, which have the high genetic purity, means they there will be high vigor and the germination and the quality as well as healthy growth of seed. And then high pure seed percentage, means which seeds will be free from the any inert matter or the sand, dust or the leaves or twigs or any part of the other plant parts or the seed, that is free from the waste material. Then high germinability means the ability of the seed should be will produce or to grow the seedlings with uniform root and shoot development. And then high vigor, that is healthy growth of the seedlings. Higher field establishment means the optimum plant stand. Whatever the seed rate are used for the sowing, which will be germinate the seeds 100% and maintain the plant 100% plant population. Then free from the pest and disease, that is free from the there is no any infection about with the pest and diseases. It is healthy seeds will be categorized as quality seed. Then seed should have the proper or good shape, size, color, and according to the specification of the variety, and should have the high viability, that is longevity or the shelf life. Then optimum moisture content for the storage should be accordingly for the long storage and the high market value. These are the qualities of the good quality seed. Next one, you can see the characteristics of good quality seed. There are different characteristics. That is, first one, the high genetic purity. That is, in breeder or the nucleus class seeds, which have the 100% genetic purity, and in foundation 99.5%. and the certified seed, that is 99.0%. Then higher physical, second one, the physical purity for certification. That is maize or the bhindi, which have the 99% physical purity. And all the other crops, most of other crops, that is 98%. And the carrot 95%. Then sesamum, soybean, jute 97%. And then groundnut 96% of the physical purity, which is used for the certification of seed. And then possession of good safe size and color according to the specification of the variety. And then higher physical soundness and weight, higher germination, then higher physiological vigor and the growth of stamina, and then higher storage capacity, then free from other crop seeds. These are the general characteristics of the good quality seed. Next one, importance of the quality seed. In this case, the ensures the genetic and physical purity of the crops. This is the major importance. Then desired, gives the desired plant population, capacity to withstand under the adverse conditions. And then seedlings produce will be more vigorous, fast growing, and can resist the pest and disease incidence to the certain extent. Then ensures the uniform plant growth and the maturity. And then development of the root system will be more efficient than the that are used for absorption of nutrients efficiently and result in higher yield. And it will be respond well to the added fertilizers and other inputs. And then quality of the good seed will be of the improved variety, ensures the higher yield at least 10 to 12%. These are the importance of the quality seed. Next one, you can see the seed treatment, second aspect. That is seed treatment concept. In the that is definition of the seed treatment, that is application of fungicide or insecticide or the combination of both to the seeds as to be disinfect or infect them from the seed borne or the soil borne pathogenic organisms and the storage insects. It is called as a seed treatment. That is the application of our seeds are treated with fungicide, insecticide, or the combination of both, as well as the biofertilizers, which will be used to disinfect them from the seed-borne or the soil-borne diseases or the pathogenic organisms, and also the storage insect pests. It will be protect from the this infection, and then also refers the subjecting of the seed to be solar energy explorer and immersions with the conditioning of water, etc. Then seed treatment or seed dressing is a chemical or typically antimicrobial or fungicidal with the which the seeds are treated or dressed prior to the planting, which is also called as seed treatment. As the seed treatment are the biological, physical or chemical agents and the techniques applied to the seed to provide the protection and improve the establishment of the healthy crops. As the seed treatment, where the application of fungicides, it may be chemicals or the different antimicrobial or fungicidal inputs are used to be for treating the or dressing the seeds before the planting to get the higher yield or healthy growth of the seedlings or the healthy growth of the crop or better establishment of the crop. That is concept of the seed treatment. As the definition of treated seed, you can see here the term treated means to give an application of pesticide or the subjects of the seed to process designed to reduce the or the control or repel the disease organisms or the insects which will be the other pests which attack on the seed or the seedlings. This is also called as the treated seeds or the seed treatment. Next one, the benefits of seed treatment. That is the five major benefits that is to get from the seed treatment. That is prevent the spread of plant diseases, then protect the seed from seed rot and the seedling blights, then improve germination, then provides protection from the storage insects, then control of the soil insects. These are the major benefits of the seed treatment. The advantages of seed treatment are the protecting the crop from the especially the disease or insect pests, along with the protect the crop with germinating the seeds as well as seedlings against the soil as well as seed borne pathogens or the insects. Then seed germination enhancement or increase early and uniform establishment and growth of the crop or the seedlings. They enhances the nodulation in leguminous crops, especially with the seeds are treated with the biofertilizers, that is rhizobium. Then better than the soil and foliar applications, the uniform crop and stand, and the, even in adverse condition, that is less or higher moisture condition. These are the advantages of seed treatment. Next one, you can see the next point, that is seed objectives of seed treatment. In this case, the major objective, that is control of disease. In case of cotton and groundnut seeds are treated with the mercury compounds, and that is to control the soil borne fungi. That is, in case of paddy, treated with the organomercurial fungicides like agrocyan or the to safeguard against the blast, or the bajri or the bajra seeds are treated with or dipped with the 20% brine solution for removing the fungi causing the argot. This is a major disease of bajra, and the blast, this is a major disease of rice, which will be treated or which will be controlled with the help of organomercurial compounds or the 20% brine solution treatment. Next point, that is convincing sowing. That is, in case of cotton, seeds is rubbed with thick cow dung slurry and dried before the sowing, so that the fibers do not entangle with the one another. The cotton seeds is also treated with the sulfuric acid to remove the fuzz, all the present in on, on the seed. Then in case of the coriander, the seed is split under the high pressure or slight pressure for even germination. That is because of the hard seed coat. Then very small seeds like bajra, ragi or tobacco are mixed with the sand, fine sands, ash and fine earth for the obtaining the even stand of the crop. This is a convincing sowing, means those crops which are difficult to do for the, especially the sowing operation, especially cotton, then small seeded crops, then in case of the coriander, which will be treated either with the concentrated istrisofer or soak with the water for softening the hard seed coat to get the early or fast germination. Next one, the quick germination, indigo lucerne seeds which have the hard seed coat may lightly pounded with the wooden pestle. Then paddy and cotton seed may be soaked with the plain water for a few hours to hasten their germination. Then protect against wild ants. The some seeds of vegetable crops may be treated with some kinds of the repellents material like the camphor or kerosene, that so that the strong smell will be keep the wild ants away. These are the four objectives of treatment. And then another objective, that is number fifth, that is protection against the insect pest. That is 10 EC entry or the that is without water is sometimes spread on the CSS1 hybrid, that is jowar sorghum, so jowar hybrid seeds just before the sowing, so that some of the insects which we eat these treated seeds will die and the further damage will be reduced. Then increase the nitrogen fixation by the legumes. That is, seeds of soybean, bursim or the groundnut may be treated with this slurry, obtaining the suitable rhizobium or rhizobial culture for better nodulation and increase the nitrogen fixation. Then inducing earliness by giving a vernalization treatment of the seed, maturity of the seed, especially for the long duration crops, is should be reduced or shortened. In this process, the seeds are soaked with the water to incipitate or to increase germination in the form of awakening of the dormancy or dormant embryo and the commencement of the changes favoring for the germination in the endosperm. Then inducing variation. For inducing variation, in its original morphological and the general structure of the seed, plant breeder give the X-ray treatment to the seeds for the protection of these changes the mutant varieties of this specific crop. That is, for example, Sarbati sonara, that is wheat, which will be mutant isolated form of gamma rays. Treated material of the sonara 64 having all the goods characters of the sonar and the addition of the amber color green instead of red color, one of the Sonara 64, and more protein and lysine percentage in the grains. These are the inducing variations. The next one, that is dormancy. The concept of dormancy, that is the ability of seed to germinate or to produce the good seedlings. This is the concept of seed germination. Then in this case, the most of the crops have the dormancy generally, that is physiological or the enforced or the innate type of dormancy is found because of due to the reason of lack of aeration or the hard seed coat or the lack of ability of the moisture. This is the major reason behind where that is to found the seed dormancy. That is, seed dormancy state or the condition in which seeds are prevented from germination even under the favorable environmental conditions for germination, including temperature, water, light, gas, or the seed coats, as well as the other mechanical restrictions. These are the factors which will be cause the seed dormancy. Or the seed dormancy is also defined as the inability of seed to germinate due to unfavorable environmental conditions, that is due to lack of moisture, lack of aeration or exchange of gases, and then due to hard seed coat or due to immature growth of seeds or the high temperature or the unavailability of light or the any other mechanical restrictions or the damages will be cause the seed dormancy. Next point we can see here, that is the major causes of seed dormancy. In this case, there are certain causes, that is light. Due to lack of availability of the light, there will be found the seed dormancy. The temperature, if the temperature is low or continuous increase or decreases, then seed dormancy or the seed cannot germinate, or inability to seed germinate will be major will be found in this temperature fluctuation condition. In hard seed coat, due to hard seed coat, the seeds are not germinate properly, or seed coat cannot absorb the moisture or the not produce the root or the shoot portion because of the hard seed coat. For example, in cotton or the forestry species, which will be the common problem in the seed coat becomes hard, then majorly found the seed dormancy. Then period after the ripening, if the specific crops should be harvested before the ripening or the before maturity, then will be cause the dormancy, or the most of the crops which will be harvested at immature stage because of especially under drought conditions, which will be majorly found the seed dormancy. And seed germination inhibitors, that is commonly the psychocell or growth, this is a major growth germination inhibitors which will be cause the most of the crops, that is cause the seed dormancy. Then immaturity of the seed embryo, that is proper, if the maturity of embryo is not well developed or then not mature properly, then majorly cause the seed dormancy. Then impermeable seed coat to water, that is the permeability of water to seed coat, it helps to increase the germination, but there is a lack of water absorption in the seed coat, then cause the seed dormancy. Then impermeability of seed to oxygen, it is same thing in the case of water, that is the in case of also in the oxygen, that is the if the lack of absorption of this or exchange of gases in the field during the germination, then will be cause the seed dormancy. Then mechanically restricted seed coat, that is due to the at the time of harvesting of the crop, the seed coat may be damaged during threshing operation or during harvesting, it will be cause this seed dormancy. And the presence of high concentrates solutes present in the soil, which will be responsible for the dormancy. These are the major causes of seed dormancy. Next one, we can see the types of seed dormancy. In this case, there are three main types, that is innate dormancy, enforced dormancy and induced dormancy. In case of innate dormancy, that is, it is a condition of the seed which is incapable of germination, even if the conditions suitable for seedling growth are supplied. And this inability of seed to germinate may be due to certain species to the embryo being immature at the time of dispersal. That is due to the unfavorable conditions or due to the immature embryo, then seed will be inability to germinate and then cause the or then called as the innate dormancy. If the in case of enforced dormancy, the condition of the seed which is capable of germination due to the environmental restrictions, that is the includes the inadequate amount of moisture, light, oxygen and the suitable temperature, that is due to incapable of germination or in crop seeds cannot be germinate due to the unfavorable or the environmental restraints, which includes the adequate amount of moisture, oxygen, light or suitable temperature, because of this is mainly found due to the hard seed coat. Or the induced dormancy, this is a type of seed dormancy which occur when the seeds as imbibed water or the lack of absorption of the water, but has to be placed under the extreme unfavorable conditions for germination. Finally, seed fails to germinate even under the more favorable conditions. This type of dormancy, that is in case of induced dormancy, the majorly found when the seed's coat of the seed has inability to absorb the moisture, then cause the dormancy, which when sown under the favorable conditions. These are the three types of dormancy. And next one, importance of seed dormancy. In this case, it follows the storage of seed for the latter use by the animals and the as well as man, then also helps to disperse the or dispersal of seeds through the unfavorable environmental conditions. Then dormancy induced by the inhibitors present in the seed coat, this should be highly useful for the especially desert plants. Then allows the seed to continue in the suspended animations without any harm during the cold or high summer temperature and under drought conditions. Then also the dormancy helps to seeds to remain alive in the seed for several years. Then also provide the continuous source of new plant even when all the mature plants of the area have died down due to the natural disaster. These are the importance of seed dormancy. Because of seed dormancy, which follow the storage of the seeds of for the latter use to the animal as well as man, and so the helps to dispersal of the seed through the unfavorable environmental conditions. The dormancy induced by inhibitors should also present in seed coat is highly useful for the desert plants. Then also allows the seed to continue to be in the suspended animations without any harm to the cold or high summer temperature. And also the dormancy helps the seed to remain alive in the seed for several years and provide continuous source of new plant even when all the mature plants of the area have died down due to the natural disaster. These are the importance of seed dormancy. Next one, you can see the concept in this chapter, that is stages of multiplication of seed or the phases of seed multiplication. That is first one, nucleus seed. In this case, the nucleus seed is generally produced by the plant breeder, which is undertaken by the supervision of the different parenting lines or the crossover under the directions of this plant breeder. And the name of proposals of the nucleus seed is completely under unalterated and is without any physical deterioration of the pollutions. And with the end goal of this accomplish this frame, it is created by the segregated domain to ensure there is no taining from the physical or hereditary elements, and it is critical to ensure that the energy of parental line is held with the core seed, and this seed have the high genetic purity, and this nucleus seed, the quantity of the harvest seed, it will be in gram or in kg, and the rights of production of nucleus seed is only undertaken by the plant breeder, and the plant breeder which will be working in the state university or the research stations, and then only rights of production of this nucleus seed, there is a plant breeders have only right to produce the nucleus seed. Next one, then genetic purity of the nucleus seed, that is 100%. Next one, the breeder seed. The breeder seed is produced from the nucleus seed or the further multiplication of the nucleus seed under the supervision of qualified plant breeder. This is also the undertaken or should produce under the supervision of plant breeder in the Research Institute of Agriculture University. This provide for the initial and the recurring increase of these foundation seed. And the breeder seed is monitored by the joint inspections team of the scientists and the officials of the certification agency and the National Seed Corporation. And the genetic purity of the breeder seed crop should be maintained, that is 99.9%, but sometimes that is 100%. This is a photograph is showing the breeder seed tag, that is a yellow in color. Next one, you can see the third one, that is foundation seed. In case of the foundation seed, there is progeny of breeder seed, and is produced by the State Farm Corporation of India and the National Seed Corporation, State Seed Corporation, under the technical control of qualified breeder or the technical officers. That is, foundation seed is produced with the by using the source as the progeny of breeder seed, and it is produced under the supervision of technical officer, which will be from the National Seed Corporation, State Seed Corporation, or the State Farm Corporation of India, which will be supervised for the this production of the foundation seed. Then its production is supervised and approved by the certification agency, and genetic purity of the foundation seed should be maintained at 99.5%, and this is the tag that is white in color, which is used in the foundation seed. Next one, that is fourth one, registered seed. That is this seed which will be for foundation seed is used as a progeny for the production of or multiplication of the registered seed. The National Seed Corporation offers guidance and technical advice to progressive farmer as well as the registered seed growers to produce the registered seed from the foundation seed which are the genetically pure, and in order to ensure the genetic purity, seed certification agency conduct the field regular field inspections and field test. These are the this is the type of registered seed which will be produced by the progressive farmer or registered seed grower under the guidance of the technical staff or the of seed certification agency, and the seed certification agency which will maintain the genetic purity by conducting the regular inspections and the field test. And this is the pink color or the color label which is used in the registered seed. Next one, that is certified seed. The certified seed is a progeny of foundation seed, and its production of is supervised and approved by the certification agency. And the seed of this class is normally produced by the state and the National Seed Corporation and private seed companies on the farms of progressive grower. And this is the commercial seed which is available for the farmers, and its genetic purity should be 99%. And this is the label or tag which is used for the certified seed. And next one, that is truthful seed. These seeds are developed and produced by the private seed companies and are sold under the label of truthful seed. In order to be able to produce the truthful seed, their field and the seed standards specified by Seed Act must be maintained by the companies. And this is a truthfully labeled seeds. And next one, that is the these are the all aspects of today's topic, that is seed, definition of seed, then qualities of good seed, characteristics of good seed, then importance of quality seed, then seed treatment types, seed dormancy, types of dormancy, importance of dormancy, then the stages of seed multiplication. Thank you.